So if I could have everyone stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I felt a lot of pressure there on that Pledge of Allegiance after Christina Aguilera blew the Star Spangled Banner. Super. I mean, what can you take for granted anymore? So, all right. We are going to get started. Councilmember Lutz is racing into the fray. And I expect Councilmember Sanchez to join us. Councilmember De La Rosa is ill. And before we get started, let me just do a little bit of housekeeping. This is a special study session devoted to one particular issue, sidewalks. Before we get started, we are obligated to take public comment on any item not on the agenda. So if there are any public comment issues in general, now's the time, and those will be 2 minutes at a throw. Seeing none, we will go ahead and jump right. Anne-Marie, don't you want to talk about sidewalks? You know, this would be kind of fun. This would be a first. I'm going to try and talk people out of public comment so we can get to sidewalks.
You're lucky, Mayor. I'm going to speak on that, and I also have a comment.
You're going to talk twice tonight?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, I catch you on the radio, you know, a lot of times.
Yes, I'm aware of that. So that's three times this week. All right. Welcome.
I was just concerned about, I know you have a short of your funding for your to do your projects and everything. And there's so much speeding all over city of Salinas. I would like to see more tickets handed out, especially on Davis, West Davis, East Davis, Blanco, anywhere you go. I mean, there's California Street, Romney Lane. There's just so much speeding. I would like to see some little motorcycles out there and hand out some nice, pretty little tickets, you know. Get some revenue into your funds, okay?
We will pass that along to the appropriate folks.
Oh, and the boom boxes. I know how many times I tell people they got their boom box people driving with the radio, I mean with their phones driving at the same time.
I stopped after I got caught.
Yeah, and all the issues, okay?
All right, thanks, Anne-Marie. Okay, anyone else? Okay, you're up next.
Yes, and kind of in line with what I've been talking about for the last 3 weeks. We pray every Tuesday, 2:30 to 3:30 in front of Planned Parenthood. And here are some brochures. Any woman who finds herself in a pregnancy, unexpected crisis, whatever. There's the Confidence Pregnancy Center on East Romney Lane, and I brought some brochures so that just to refresh your memory that there's a positive place that respects life.
Okay, thank you, Joe.
Thank you for your time. I know you got scheduled stuff ahead. You know, I've been in the private sector a long time, corporate employee, corporate owner, and I know where the city is facing a shortfall. And I was quite alarmed to read last week in the paper that that there was a team hired to come in here and give the city some advice. Professionals came in, sized things up, and their recommendation was to, you know, pretty straightforward in my mind, at least the way it read, was you need to cut staff and you need to do benefit reform. And I don't know why there's all this hand-wringing, and I certainly don't want more cops on the streets giving out speeding tickets, for gosh sakes. It seems pretty simple in my mind, and again, I've been in the private sector for 30 years. When faced with challenges that challenge your business plan as a city, you need to take proactive choices, and they're not always easy. And you know, losing jobs is not anything anybody wants to go through. But the time for going through and soliciting ideas for saving money was 4 or 5 years ago. Our backs are up against the wall here as a city, and I would hope that the professional's advice would be revisited, which is cut staff and reform benefits. Every business out there is doing it.
I will ask you to leave the chambers. We have for those who are not familiar with how we do business here, democracy is not a spectator sport. We deliberate. There's no cheering. There's no booing.
I respect that. Thank you.
No, and I can tell. We have an excited newcomer, which is fine. So I just want to caution her on the rules of engagement.
I hope that, you know, the hand-wringing would stop and some constructive, proactive choices be made by the city to fill this gap. And then when times get better, which I honestly believe they will at some point, then we can start thinking about, you know, either reintroducing those services or bringing staff back on hand.
Okay.
So
thank you.
Thank you very much.
You bet. Thanks for your time.
Good afternoon, real quick, Mayor and Council. I just wanted to mention again that we're still hoping that the work will start on Market Street. It's been a while, and I know they once had permit problems, and now they got underwater seepage, and people in China need more rice. You know, a lot of excuses, but not a whole lot being done. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Mary Ann Warden. Al just reminded me of something I've been wanting to tell you folks. We could have saved a lot of money by getting rid of these palm trees. And we begged and pleaded no palm trees on Market Street. Sure enough, we're putting palm trees on Market Street. Now, I've been there for 40, you know, almost 50 years here, or over 50 years. And until when I came here, palm trees were only over the Hardin Ranch. Do you know how much problems those things cause? During our windstorm, they had, you know, the bark falls off and it flies across into the street between the mud and the thing. I almost stopped to pick it up, but I knew there was no way I could even pick them up because I was willing to bring them down here to show you the mess they make on the streets. And those barks, they'll come right on top of your hood. And then the branches will come on your windshield wiper and get caught when you're wiping and almost cause an accident. So why put something that's costing us money? Because nobody, I've yet to see any city person up there cleaning those palm branches or trimming the bark. I've yet to see them do that. So plant something that's not so costly and so dangerous. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, I'm going to close public comment, and we are going to proceed to the study session. All right, we've certainly have had study sessions before. And the intent, let me just a quick little background before we proceed to staff report. All of us have on the dais have the latitude of district meetings. What I want to try and do, so this will be a little not so much an experiment, but I want to take an issues-oriented approach to things that all of us up here are aware are important on a very personal basis, because at some level we all got a sidewalk and been a historical problem for the city. So the format for this evening should be fairly straightforward. We're going to receive a staff report, which will kind of outline the history of the problem. Then council will ask questions, and then we do want to hear public comment. Now, I think we've got a good turnout, which is terrific. I'm going to be mindful of, we've set a 4 to 6 o'clock time on this, and that is going to be observed. So we'll go ahead and go with the normal 2 minutes, unless I sense that we need to tighten it up for the sake of staying within that mark. Because one of the things we do need to be able to do is come back to council for final comments and some direction. We want your time to be well spent, and one of the things we can do tonight is provide some direction on this issue. So that'll be kind of the time frame. It looks to me like we can generally get that done, and everyone should be able to feel free to comment. I want to reiterate the way we work. 2 minutes. I honor creative use of the English language. If you're really good at run-on sentences, know how to do semicolons and commas, you get to finish your thought, but once you hear the bell ring. And then I just want a reminder, because frankly, this is a tough issue. This is probably one where nobody's going to be happy. So reminder, we ain't cheering, we ain't booing. We're here together because we're your neighbors up here trying to serve you as best we can to try and deal with an issue that frankly, I pass no judgment on it other than to say, as far as the residents of this community, is this can has been kicked for a couple of decades now. So let's look at it straight on and see if we can come up with a better solution. So with that in mind, we're going to look for Jim Pia, and he will start off with a staff report.
Thank you, Mayor, members of council. Good afternoon. We are here to take a look at the sidewalk policy, and just some ground rules. I will be presenting part of this, as will Vanessa in legal and Tom in finance. This was a team effort. Let's talk a moment about urban forestry. Much of the problem we have, and we'll get to the problems on sidewalks, begin with actually a beautiful setting of trees, of urban forestry, a setting of trees, and the importance and benefits of trees can't be underestimated. They are certainly aesthetically pleasing. They create a safer walking environment. They provide added value to property, homes, and businesses. They help increase neighborhood pride. They absorb pollutants. They protect us from rain and sun and heat. And they often soften street features, even the trash cans you see in that street-lined setting. So our objectives tonight are to look at the problem, the history of the problem, what our current policy is, and the problem with sidewalks, and the vast majority of sidewalk problems do stem from the trees, and that's why I began with trees. And the current policy is that we have a list. The well-known number is about 2,000 property addresses on the list, and the list was derived on a first-come, first-served basis dating back the same 2 decades, Mayor, that you mentioned in terms of kicking the can. And we'll get to how that list is looked on. We're about 10 to 12 years behind on that list. Or, for example, we're looking at problems now about 1998 is what we're fixing. We have aging infrastructure to include the gutters and the sidewalks. Oftentimes, this has been a tree selection, not in modern day, but in yesteryear issue. A couple of known culprits are the magnolia, liquid amber trees. And so tree selection has played a role, as our budgets, and not just the most recent budgets, but the budget of repairing streets and sidewalks and gutters and curbs has always had a finite amount affixed to those. Again, this is a complaint-driven system with nearly 2,000 reported sites. It should be noted that we estimate there are a few more thousand. We don't have a current program to be counting those, but those are the only of the sites reported. We're working on repairs from 98. Temporary repairs are done usually within a couple of weeks, where we will go to the site and often ramp up, if you will, with asphalt to eliminate the 1-2 inch or whatever is reported in terms of the trip and fall aspect. So we will ramp it up. So the repair of the temporary repair is actually done fairly quickly before a permanent repair then goes on to the list. I noted we have limited resources available. How do we fix the, what is the cost, or how do we fix the problem? The city budget includes a portion of gas tax money for these repairs. In the current fiscal year we're in, it's about $400,000, just over $400,000. It includes our full-time staff, our materials, and new this year, $75,000 to Rancho Cielo, which is more of an apprentice program, and they've actually repaired